If your family is anything like mine, when it comes to light the Hanukkah candles, we chant the brachot in the traditional melodic tune and end candle lighting with the singing of Ma'os Sur, for which I've also only heard one tune. In between, we quickly make our way through the recitation of Hanerot Halalu, starting off with a melody for the first line, and then speeding through the rest of it relatively quickly, because we don't actually have a tune that fits the words. In our haste to complete the Hanerot Halalu, we run the risk of glossing over the meaning of what we are saying, which is essentially an explanation for why we're lighting Hanukkah candles, and some of the assorted halachot which pertain to the candles. One of the things we say is that we are obligated, lehodot ulehalel, to give thanks and praise to Hashem for the miracle and salvation of Hanukkah. We give thanks by reciting Al Hanisim during Birkat HaMazon and Shmoneh Esrei, and give praise through the daily recitation of Halal at Shacharit. Rav Kook, in his commentary to the Siddur, offers a different explanation. Rav Kook argues that lehodot means that we should thank God for saving us from the brink of destruction by enabling the few to defeat the many, but lehalel means that we should praise Hashem for the good that remained with the Jewish people as a direct result of what was an overall negative encounter with Greek culture, namely the Socratic method, which, as Rav Kook writes, was refined and purified for use in the study of Torah. According to Rav Kook, we owe the give and take, the questions and answers style of the Talmud, and the methods through which we learn Torah to Greek culture. We need to see the light in everything and praise God for it. For me, Rav Kook's message is particularly meaningful this Hanukkah. In a year which has been so difficult for mankind, it is incumbent upon us, lehalel, to find our own personal silver linings in the pandemic that has affected our entire way of life. Some of the most memorable moments of this past year involved people demonstrating a sense of achrayut and caring for one another and their families. While I have not seen my parents for over 9 months, this Hanukkah I choose lehalel for my immediate family, who because of this terrible pandemic I have been able to spend more time with, to do homework with, to put to sleep, and also just to speak with one another in a way that I had not previously allowed myself to do. As you celebrate and light your Hanukkiah this year, even if you're like me and you don't really have a good tune for Hanerot Halalu, I urge you to think about your own personal silver linings and lehalel. Offer praise for the good that has come from this difficult year.